in the simplest terms, we're qualifying our products to ensure that they have the quality imaging that we require to move forward. That's phase one. And then as we transition through phase one, we go into phase two, where we're testing in larger groups in sick patients and doing comparables and collecting all the data that's required for our FDA applications in 2025.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. Joining me now is Brent Willis. He's the CEO of Voyageur Pharmaceuticals. And Brent, welcome back. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you too.
So last time you and I talked, you talked about the next selection of your products that you're going to be launching. And in you just had a news release out talking that starting in Q1, so right away, in fact, you're going to be doing some human testing on those. So let's take a step back and remind everyone a little bit about these products that are going to be released and what they'll be used for.
Sure. We have five Health Canada licensed products. They're barium contrast products used in X-ray and CT. And in radiology, we require drugs to highlight the images, and these drugs are in short supply. The minerals required to manufacture them are in short supply, and North America is 100% import dependent. So we're looking at filling the gaps by reducing the supply chain issues and being a sole provider in North America for radiology drugs.
So as we mentioned, it's a number of them: SmoothX, SmoothHD, LD, VisionHD, and VisionLD. So as I mentioned, they're going to go through some rigorous testing. So tell me how this testing will work and what you're hoping to get out of this. What kind of markers you're looking for?
Sure, we're testing in a clinical setting, and in the simplest terms, we're qualifying our products to ensure that they have the quality imaging that we require to move forward. That's phase one. And then as we transition through phase one, we go into phase two, where we're testing in larger groups in sick patients and doing comparables and collecting all the data that's required for our FDA applications in 2025. So in the US, it's classified as a drug, and in Canada, it's classified as a health supplement. So we have a lot of leeway in Canada moving forward. We can get into sales very quickly. And as we transition with the FDA, we are expecting sales in the US in 2026.
Yeah. So in essence, you're hoping to have these products available for purchase in 2025 here in Canada, and then, as you mentioned, in the US in the following year.
That's right. Canada and international markets that accept Health Canada licensing, we're targeting those markets as well. So we're expecting revenue here to begin generating here sometime within the first half of 2025. We're working to get that done as early as possible, of course, and we'll transition our products and displace the current products that are in the market slowly over this next year, and then really ramp up sales in 2026.
Yeah. And one last question, Brent, and I know you've asked this, I've asked you this before, but I find it intriguing that the fact that this particular space hasn't really had anything new in it for quite some time. Can you talk sort of about the space that you're going into?
Yeah, we're going up against one large big pharma company that has a dominant for years in this segment with the barium contrast. And we're also adding to our portfolio iodine. We're creating some iodine products down the road here, and we're looking at fully vertically integrating that with producing our own iodine minerals. So we're all about vertical integration, and that's where we stand out, because when you vertically integrate, you're producing your own strategic minerals that are required for these drugs, and no one does that. And when you do that, you reduce your costs significantly.
Yeah. Brent, thanks so much. I look forward to hearing more about the testing when it gets completed. And we'll have you back, of course, to update on everything that's going on with the company. So I appreciate your time today. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Brent Willis, the CEO of Voyageur Pharmaceuticals.